Place imaginable. Angus McIndoe. You love Angus McIndoe here on 44th Street between Broadway and 8th. The food is amazing. The stars are amazing. All the Broadway stars and some of them who are film stars too come here. And I have to say also, happy Hanukkah, because our guest today is Jewish. He's a real super Jew. He's one of the stars of Survivor Tocantins, but he's one of the greatest reality show contestants ever, as far as I'm concerned. He's smart, he's articulate, he's intelligent, he went to Yale. I thought, okay, I'll do reality TV. And you know something? Stephen Fishbach is all those things, and he's gonna be here in a few minutes, so that's why I'm saying happy Hanukkah too today here at Angus McIndoe's. The food here, oh my God, the atmosphere. And there's Stephen, okay. We'll be right back. Another first here today at Angus McIndoe's, probably for the restaurant itself, which has such fabulous food. You've got to come here on 44th Street in the heart of the theater district. You'll see every star you've ever wanted to see. Yes, they're all here. We're on the third floor and we're here talking to Stephen Fishbach, one of the stars of Survivor Tocantins. Hey, Stephen.
Hello, and I'm very excited to be the first reality person ever on your show.
I know, I've never done this before, so I've got all these questions and just sort of, you know, you're a young guy. You must have grown up with reality TV, watching it and stuff.
I remember 2001, rooting for Richard Hatch to win, you know, certainly never
I
thinking
did too.
That now,
yeah.
Who didn't? He was America's favorite villain.
Yes, and I've been watching, this is a guilty secret finally being revealed, I've watched every single episode of Survivor since it started. Anyway, almost.
That's more than I've seen, for sure.
But Survivor Tocantins, Stephen, you came in second, you won $100,000.
Second is close, it's not quite first, but I was, you know, there
you
at the end, 39
game,
days.
And they edited, I mean, because we're going to be talking all about reality TV, and if you don't care about Survivor and you want to just tune out now, do it. But Stephen has a great, great personality and a great sense of humor, and you were terrific.
Okay.
Well, I have so many questions. How did you get on it?
So I actually certainly never thought I would be on Survivor, and I was emailed out of the blue by someone in casting that said, hey, do you want to be on Survivor? And I, of course, at first thought, absolutely not. Why would I want to do that? You know, it's reality, it's trashy.
You?
It was someone I knew who worked in casting. And what happened was they had already cast the whole show. And they had a goofy nerd guy who they didn't like. So they needed a new goofy nerd. And I fit the bill. They came to me. I turned it down. You know, and then I kind of had second thoughts, and I went through the process.
But you're not goofy or nerdy in person. He's really quite handsome, as you're seeing.
That's
today.
Right. I'm sort of a star.
Yeah, you are. You really are.
Not at all. No, I'm a geeky city guy. You know, that's and I fit the type that they were looking for, and I made it on the show. You know, they cast in these archetypes. You've got the strung out old lady, the southern charmer, the goofy city guy, the leading man, and I happen to be one of those.
So did you were asked to be on, you didn't have to like send in a video as most people do and go through a whole process. Did you have to go through a process where they took you to a hotel or something?
Sure. Everybody
you
has
that.
To
okay,
apply.
Okay, well tell us, you've never heard about this, have you? I think it's outrageous. But I mean, this is how it's done.
Well, I mean, I can't
part
reveal
of
all of the secrets of the magic. Like CBS's, you know, book-length contract.
All right, how
forbids
big is
me.
It?
It's actually about this big. I got
that's
a huge box of legal forms to sign. But I can say that everyone has to submit a tape where you just sort of pitch yourself to the world and
you did
CBS,
that.
And I did that.
You did that even though they called you.
Yeah, I mean, even the people who are called, everyone has to go through the casting process, you know, so that it's fair and so that they know who you are. You have to have psychological exams, you know, so that you're fit.
Psychological exams?
Well, just so that, you know, they know that you're fit for the intense experience of Survivor.
Well, I mean, basically, for those who don't know, I've been living in the jungle of the city. You're thrown out into usually a jungle kind of situation. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I couldn't get past the, I mean, once upon a time, I looked at the form, and the first question I said, oh, no, forget it. I just did not qualify for that show. But you qualified for the Stephen Holt show because, I mean, I thought you were so interesting. And so, you had this great personality, I thought, and a great sense of humor, and a great intelligence. You were the smartest person that's ever been on any reality show I've ever seen.
Allegedly, they've got a guy in season 19, Samoa, who's the smartest one ever, although we'll see how...
I haven't noticed that trait yet. We're shooting this ahead of time, so if we talk about Survivor Samoa, whatever we have to say is going to be out of date.
It's old news.
But the news also being you ended up having this wonderful blog on people.
That's right.
.com.
I'm blogging about the strategy of Survivor for people.com.
You're a wonderful writer.
Well, thank you very much.
Is that what you want to do?
Yeah, I like it. Yeah, I enjoy writing a lot.
And you went to Yale.
Yes, I went to Yale undergrad. Studied English, and now I'm writing.
Because I thought for sure you would go into the Yale School of Drama, because our last guest, Alessandro Nivolo, also went to Yale and he was majoring in English or something too, and look what's happened to him.
Oh, he's a real star.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're on the Stephen Holt show, the only one. You've got potential, young man. Well, I mean, if you want to, do you want to be an actor?
No, I'm one of the few people on Survivor who has no ambitions to act.
Would you, if...
I mean, you know, it's like if someone calls you about Survivor, you know, you're not going to turn down an opportunity if it comes your way, but I would certainly never pursue it, and I would be skeptical about it.
Yeah, well, I think you would be great. I mean, certainly you've come over well on camera. So you sent in your video, and they're all like, they called you already. So they were already like behind you. And then what happens? You had to get taken to this,
you know, there's this
remote location in Los Angeles or something.
You go to Los Angeles, there's an interview process, you know, different stages of production. You see Mark Burnett from across the room. He's charming. He has a beautiful smile. He's the producer of the show. And
he started it all.
Then a month before the show starts, they say, okay, get ready because you're going to go.
Can you talk about what you did, went through in that hotel?
I can't talk about it.
You can't tell. Yeah. I can.
It's a big secret.
I've read that you can't talk to anybody out at all, and everyone is sort of isolated, and it's sort of this experience where they have to see if you can take isolation. You can't call anybody, your friends, your family, whatever. And Stephen isn't copping to this, but, you know, that's what I've heard. And I just thought, I can't do that!